Hi, friends, and welcome to another edition of Keeping Up with the Jackrabbits. I'm Tyler Merriam. It is great to have you with us. It is almost Hobo Week. Can you believe it? We've almost reached the end of October. Joining us this week on the show, a member of the Jackrabbit Athletic Training Crew, assistant athletic trainer working with women's basketball, Loran Strunk. Loran, how are you?
I'm doing great, Tyler. It's great to hear your voice. I haven't heard from you in about 8 months. So
it just feels so disjointed. The conversations that used to be just regular occurrences, we live in a much different world right now, don't we?
Well, we do. Oh, my gosh. I just remember always passing you in the hallways and being able to say, hey, and I don't really see you anymore. So different world.
It is. The only positive of doing this over Zoom is we actually get to see our faces as opposed to the masks that we see so often. So that's at least a positive of all of this. But we can talk about the current nature of things in a moment, but I want to backtrack a little bit. How does someone like you with Florida and South Carolina as a background end up in South Dakota? What made this Southern girl trek north?
Well, I always tell people, they're like, oh my gosh, you come here in all this snow. Why? I don't understand. And somebody actually asked me the question the other day, but you know, it's one of those things like you don't necessarily grow up with it. So it's still new. It's still something very exciting. Now, I mean, some mornings I'm like, okay, can this be gone? Can this be done type thing?
But so are we.
No, it's right. But there's, I mean, just so many more doors for opportunity. Obviously, you have like snowboarding, cross-country skiing, that type of thing. So just other activities to do. Definitely a different world, I will say. Even the people, I would say, are nicer. I think that's why I'm here as long as I have been. So no. But no, just overall, South Dakota has been a great place. And the Jackrabbit community has been awesome. They've been unbelievable. So and they've kind of welcomed me as one of their own. So I'm forever grateful for that.
Well, we are grateful to have you here. It's been a little more than 3 years. Time flies, Loran. It's been over 3 years since you came
here.
I
know. It's crazy. Time flies when you have fun, they say, right?
Well, we certainly are having a lot of fun. There's no question about that. Now, you talked about some of the things that you try to do, snowboarding and all this and that, but how many days in a row, what's the streak now that you've run?
It's been about 2 years, full 2 years in a row that I've run. Haven't taken a day off, so crazy, right?
Is there a minimum distance to be able to keep the streak alive?
I try to run at least a mile a day, but this year I'm actually doing something very crazy, and people would probably say that I'm crazy for doing it, but I had a crazy idea of doing 2,020 miles in 2020.
Wow.
And to do quick math for you, that's about 5.5 miles every day for an entire year. So it's definitely had its up and downs. My body hates me, my knees mostly, but sleep and nutrition has been very important for my health and mental sanity.
I do not doubt that in the least. With all of this, it was very hyped up on one of the episodes. I don't even remember what we called it at that point with the women's basketball program, that we had the jump shots with Jewett, and then it was thoughts with Thunic, and it bounced around to all these different things. But you and Kaylee Costello teamed up on a very unique event. Tell me about what you guys decided to do.
Okay, this is also where you're going to probably think I'm crazy. But
that ship's already sailed, Loran.
So kind of backtracking, we were supposed to run what's called last man standing race. So it's essentially a loop of 4 miles that you do every hour on the hour until you're the last person in the race. So we were essentially training for that. And part of our training, we were like, oh, well, we should run to Sioux Falls and do increments of like 5 miles. So that's essentially how that began.
Really. Sounds lovely, Loran.
Right? Great idea, right? Okay, this is also during like when COVID was first brand new. So you're at home a lot, obviously not being able to exercise, whatever, go to work as much. So that was kind of our idea. And then we started to draw out 5 mile increments, and it really became a thing. So it was 60 miles, 5 mile increments of running and biking. And honestly, I don't know that I would ever do it again.
It is one of those things, and we've all had them, not obviously like that, but we've all done them where you get done with it, and it's a really cool story to tell. But like you said, there's also the, I'm glad I did it, but I'm never doing that again.
Never, never. Not the same way, I will say. Not the same way.
So the first 2 years you were here at SDSU, you did not work with women's basketball, and then you switched over to that program. What's it been like working with the women?
You know, being in athletics, it's all the same. Obviously, it's Division I, so they're set at a higher standard, I would say. But working with women's basketball and volleyball has been awesome. Like I said in the beginning, like the atmosphere, being a Jackrabbit, the community is just so inviting. So regardless of the sport that I work with, they're all the same. I mean, it's just a very great experience to be able to move anywhere and obviously make the best out of any situation has been awesome.
What has impressed you the most about the student athletes, watching them go through all of this with COVID-19 and so much change to, again, they are living usually structured lives of, this is how we work out, this is how we eat, this is how we do this, and then everything gets thrown into a complete loop. What's impressed you about how they've dealt with all of this?
Oh, their mentality. They've been through so much, and I don't think necessarily the public sees that. Obviously, everybody's world's changed, but I think they're the ones that are kind of held in limbo the most. Obviously, like, everybody has questions that need to be answered, but they're ultimately the ones that are kind of waiting around, and they do a lot of work, early mornings, lift, they do rehab, they do preventative stuff with me, then they go to practice, and they still have to be students. So just kudos to all the athletes. It's definitely crazy lifestyle, rough on the body, but good thing they have athletic trainers and good admin staff to take care of them, right?
They are in good hands with Loran Strunk. Now, I want to get down to the serious task at hand. This is the big question I've been waiting to ask. Who's the best athlete among the athletic trainers?
The best athlete? Oh, you know, I'd get hurt if I answered that.
You're allowed to answer yourself. Give yourself a little pat on the back. That's okay.
Okay, well, then myself.
There you go. Who was in contention, though? Who are you thinking about saying?
You know, Chantel, she's actually been doing what's called Squat-tober, where you essentially lift, or you squat at least every workout for every day of October. So jeez. I give her some props for that. So
see, I could see Leah creeping in there.
She's up there too. Leah Chantel.
Let it be known that Ben Hines's name never came up in this conversation. You're just going to let that one lie, aren't you?
Just going to let it go.
Ben, let the record show. So as we get back here, hopefully we get some basketball going. I know practices, of course, are running and you've been handling that. But as we get here towards November and just looking forward to having some sports again.
Oh, gosh, to be able to watch the girls play basketball, the men, and watch football, soccer, all of the sports, obviously, that would be ideal. And obviously practicing and working towards getting able to play kind of get your hopes up. So I'm hoping that everything will work out. Obviously, it's really different from what everybody's used to, but I think it'll be positive. It'll work out as long as we follow all the rules, CDC guidelines, we'll be okay.
Cross your fingers, and let's hope that you and I are on a trip with a couple of basketball teams together in the very near future, Loran.
Yes.
Thank you.
You and I both.
Thank you for your time. Always good to catch up, and let's see each other real soon.
Thank you, Tyler.
It's Loran Strunk. I'm Tyler Merriam. Thanks for joining us on Keeping Up with the Jackrabbits.